Hey guys, welcome back. Today is the final part of It's Not My Fault, and it's the second part of No Problem. Just when they were on the porch and it was pouring rain, Mrs. Chang heard her phone ring. It sounded out of place on the porch. My phone, it's not in the car, it's in my pocket, she cried out. I forgot I had it. She pulled it out and answered, Flowers to go, how can I help you? Mrs. Bradshaw, how nice to hear from you. Mrs. Bradshaw, Lucas thought. I was sure she would never call again. Why, certainly I can get lilies for you, but I'm away from my office right now. Can I call you back later this afternoon? Great, thanks so much. Mrs. Bradshaw is ordering from you again, Lucas blurted out when his mother clicked off the phone. I thought she was through with you after that mistake last week. Mother looked puzzled. Lucas, that's not the way people do business. There was a mistake in her order. I offered to get her the right flowers as soon as possible. She ended up very happy with flowers to go. Lucas asked quietly, even though you told her the mistake was your fault? Mrs. Chang spoke as she dialed a number on her phone. Yes. People don't expect you to be perfect. They just want to know that if it's your fault, you'll do whatever you can to make it right. She listened for a minute and then, Hi, it's me. You'll never guess what happened. While she explained to his dad, Lucas thought hard about what she had said. Well, he says to try all the doors and windows of the house first, and if we can't get in, we'll call a locksmith. Mom, Lucas took a deep breath. I'm sorry about locking the keys in the car. It was all my fault. I should have listened to you. I do the stupidest things sometimes. Mrs. Chang wrapped her arms around Lucas's wet jacket. I forgive you. It'll be okay. I understand how you feel, Lucas, because I do the same things. What? She squeezed him again. You're not stupid. You're just forgetful. Sometimes I'm afraid that if I admit everything is my fault, Lucas confessed, everyone will think I'm stupid and no one will like me. I think I must be the dumbest, most forgetful person in the world. Mrs. Chang snorted. Where do you think you got your forgetfulness? Why do you think I have to carry this blue notebook around all the time? Lucas looked at her. You mean you're forgetful? Like me? His mother smiled. Oh, yes. I forget everything. I have to write notes about things and leave messages for myself. Lots of things. So I understand how you feel. Lucas looked at his mother differently all of a sudden. She's just like a real person, he thought. Just don't forget that it's okay to make mistakes. Offer to make things right if you can and then go on. She shook a finger in his face. Whatever else you forget, always remember that nothing you ever do will change how much I love you. Suddenly, Lucas felt all warm inside. Outside was still cold and wet, but inside felt great. I'll check the doors and windows, Mom. I'll find us a way in. The next day in school, Lucas was following Jared past Ricky's desk on the way out to recess. His coat slid across and knocked off her pencils. Sorry, Lucas said quickly. My fault. I'll pick them up for you. When he straightened everything back up to set the pencils on Ricky's desk, he looked at her. She was smiling. No problem. Come on, Lucas, let's go, Jared called from the door. No problem, Lucas said. I'm on my way. His smile lasted all the way to the soccer field. Oh, that was a good story. Always remember to try to take responsibility for things you do, and people will be grateful for it. See you tomorrow for more stories with Macy and friends. Bye for now.